Hey y'all, Jen here from Finder.com. Today we're breaking down cryptocurrency for you, from where it began to whether you should invest in coins right now. If you want to skip ahead, go ahead and click the timestamps in the description box below. Okay, first things first, what exactly is cryptocurrency? Cryptocurrency gets its name by combining two existing concepts, cryptography and currency. Cryptography, which is the art of writing and solving codes, is a key concept of cryptocurrency. Just as cryptographers use secret codes in wartime to hide messages, or Dan Brown used cryptography to hide secrets in the Da Vinci Code, cryptocurrency uses code to protect itself and secure its blockchains. And currency? Well, you all know it's the good greens you use to buy things with. Money, dollar bills, Benjamins, whatever you want to call it. In simple terms, cryptocurrency is a form of money that's secured using codes, something government-issued money or fiat currency lacks. So where did cryptocurrency even come from? It goes back to late 2008 when an anonymous person or group of people known by the pseudonym Satoshi Nakamoto registered the domain bitcoin.org. Bitcoin's founder has yet to be officially confirmed. And to make matters fishier, a Japanese-American man actually named Satoshi Nakamoto has denied any involvement with the digital currency. Documentation for the first Bitcoin was introduced in the form of a white paper in late 2008, with the creation of the first ever Bitcoin in January 2009. We may never learn why Nakamoto created Bitcoin, but we can wager a guess. Contained in the first ever Bitcoin block, called the Genesis block, Nakamoto left us a clue. A January 3rd, 2009 London Times headline, "Chancellor on brink of second bailout for banks." Before moving forward, let's connect two features of cryptocurrency to real-world ideas to make them easier to understand. First up is blockchains, which are shared records of who owns what. Whenever someone buys or sells a coin, everyone's blockchain copies update at the same time. Blockchains are similar to an email thread, where everyone CCs one another to nail down dates for an event. The second is called mining. This is where the cryptography part of cryptocurrency kicks in. Every time a new block is added to the chain, a challenging cryptography puzzle must be solved. The folks trying to solve it are all called miners. Miners are the organizers of the email thread who continually solve the problem of scheduling, comparing suggested event dates against everyone's calendars. While we don't know what inspired the creation of the first Bitcoin, we do know what came after. Cryptocurrency can be broken down into two types. One is a store of value. Coins like Bitcoin and Litecoin are designed to replace your gold, jewels, Beanie Baby stashes, and any money you have hiding under your mattress. They exist as a place to safely store wealth and protect it from inflation. Two, it's a home for smart contracts. Cryptocurrency like Ethereum and Cardano exists not to store value, but to help clever, automated computer programs carry out tasks while everyone watches. In a public blockchain, nothing is private, so no one has to trust one another. Smart contracts lean on this trustless environment to fulfill tasks among strangers. Need to lend money to someone you don't trust? Use a smart contract to guarantee they pay you back. All of this sounds awesome, right? A lot of folks seem to think so, which has driven the total market value of cryptocurrencies to over $2 trillion, putting the collective value of the crypto market above some of the wealthiest companies in the world. Now you're probably thinking to yourself, how do I get a slice of that crypto pie? You can get cryptocurrency in one of three ways. First up is through a cryptocurrency exchange. Similar to investing in stocks, you can buy crypto through sites, apps, and even PayPal. We've gathered the easiest ways to buy cryptocurrency below. Second up, you can buy it with cash. You can find websites offering to arrange meetups for folks to buy cryptocurrency in cash, but we don't recommend this method unless you know exactly what you're doing. Vetting sellers and verifying that your deal is legit can be very, very tricky.
C is just as good. In fact, it's better. It's two more than X.
And third, you can get cryptocurrency by earning it. If you're tight on cash, you can earn cryptocurrency by mining, which is hard, earning crypto as a wage, which is a bit easier, or in microdoses by completing surveys and other small tasks online. So, is cryptocurrency worth buying? If you follow the crypto market, you may be on the fence about buying your first coin. In which case, I cannot stress this enough. Research, read, and then read some more. We've got a small trove of crypto guides on finder.com, so consider making that your first research pit stop. The bottom line is that investing in anything, crypto, real estate, plush collectibles, does anybody still collect Beanie Babies?
Oh, what a loser!
Is a speculative activity. And speculative activity comes with risk. With that in mind, here's what to know when starting your crypto journey. Cryptocurrency trades 24/7, 365 days a year, and no one can stop them. Remember when brokers halted trades of GameStop when its stock price went bananas? That can't happen with crypto. Bitcoin could go from $60,000 to $100,000 and back down to zero in 20 minutes, and no one would be able to do a darn thing about it. Next, research the coin you want to invest in to understand what makes it attractive. Does it have a purpose? If so, what is it? Does it have a strong history of development? You wouldn't buy the stocks of a company that just launched and you'd never heard of, right? Same goes for crypto. Also, figure out why people are buying it. And lastly, do not FOMO buy, please. Fear of missing out can lead beginners to chase multiple hot coins with as many losses likely as gains. Wish you'd bought 100 Bitcoin in 2010? Get in line, folks. And most importantly, no one has absolute answers. Will Bitcoin go to $100,000? Possibly. Will Bitcoin drop to $10,000? Maybe. Looking to arm yourself with information so that you can make better financial decisions? We've got you covered. Check out our guides on cryptocurrency at finder.com, linked below.